We've got baseball from the banks of the Allegheny, PNC Park in Pittsburgh. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the Oakland A's and the Chicago White Sox. White Sox baseball starts right now. Josh Harrison stands in, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Vaughn is there to put it away for route number one. And now, Starling Marte. Bases are empty, one man out. Takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Next to hit is Matt Olson. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
And he lays off it to even the count 2-2.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Throw over to Abreu is in time, and with it, the side is retired. Now at the plate here is Tim Anderson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And a dive, but it rattles in and out of the glove. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Batting second, the center fielder, Louis.
In now, Luis Robert. Called strike two on the cutter, and he's behind in the count now, 1-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue.
I'll tell you right now, he let go of that one, and he wanted to pull it back. That was a hanger, bad spot over the heart of the plate. He's lucky. He's lucky that's getting sent back to him.
Olson is there, one away. So here's the slugging first baseman, Jose Abreu now. First appearance for him here with the leadoff man still at second and one gone now. 2-1 the count to the White Sox first baseman. Swung on and missed, and it's even at 2-2.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Looks at a sinker for a called third strike, and now there are two gone. And now here's the cleanup hitter for the White Sox, Eloy Jimenez. Lifetime versus this arm. He's 2-for-4. The 2-2 pitch. Popped him up. Olson in foul ground. And that will end the inning. Second inning set to go, and standing in is the veteran outfielder Mark Canna. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Ball inside.
Ah. 2-1 pitch is a cut fastball taken for strike two. Drilled to first. Taken in by Abreu, and he'll take this to the bag himself, and the leadoff man set down to start the second. Ready now is Seth Brown. 3-2 pitch. Hit hard down the right field line. But this is going to land foul, so they'll tee it up again, 3-2. Payoff pitch one more time. Now a swing and a miss. He struck him out, and it's two up, two down to start the second. Stepping in next, Matt Chapman. prior history in this matchup. Just a 2-for-14 line, so advantage pitcher here. He's gone down on strikes 8 times as well. And that'll get down for what should be extra bases. Around second now and headed for third. And he is all the way over to third now with a 2-out triple.
Seven. The designated hitter, Chris Davis.
Into the box, Chris Davis. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. 2-2. Here it is. Tried to get him with the cutter, but it's a full count, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And they'll escape danger here after the 2-out triple as the inning is over. So stepping in is Yoan Moncada, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. Cutter, and that's a called strike two. Now a ball lined to the left side. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning. Now in the box, Yosmani Grandal, for his career in this matchup. He's hitless in 3 at-bats. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Here comes the 1-2. Is laid off for ball 2. Bottom of the second here with no score. Weak grounder back to the mound. And there's out number 2. Next will be the designated hitter, Gavin Sheets, to try to make something happen with 2 gone in the bottom of the second. And the 3-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Brown gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. Top of the third set to get underway, and set to go is the second baseman, Tony Kemp. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. So now into the box is Sean Murphy. His career numbers against this pitcher, he's 0-for-5. 2-1 pitch is a fastball swung on and missed, 2-2.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Now back.
Standing in now, Josh Harrison. It's 2-1 to the A's leadoff batter. Harrison in front, 3 balls and a strike. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Center fielder on the run, lays out, and he's got it. A great play for route number 2.
The center fielder, number 2, Darlene Marquez.
2 out, runner in scoring position at second, and that'll bring up Starling Marte. Here's the 2-1.
Outside, that's a ball.
Matt Olson would be next if they can keep this inning alive. The 3-1 pitch.
We got 3-2.
He somehow gets that one by him. 3-2 now.
You know he wants to end this inning right here on 3-2, but I don't think we'll see him lay one in on the next pitch there with the base open to work with.
Fielded cleanly. Throw over to Abreu is in time, and with it, the side is retired. Now to the plate, here is Andrew Vaughn as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third. And now in the box, Cesar Hernandez, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
And for me, this is the side he looks more fluid from. A little more control in his swing, and it seems to lead to more consistent contact than from the right side.
Here's the 2-1. I think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two. And a cut fastball, but this bounces near the plate for a ball. And he fouls this one off. Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. One there. On to first to complete the double play. So base is empty now after the double play. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Tim Anderson. Swing and a miss for strike three. Pulled the string on him that time, and the inning is over. All set for the start of the fourth, and that brings in the big power hitting first baseman Matt Olson.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. Well, if you love pitching and defense, this has been a game for you. Are you happy with that, Dan? There's a swing and a missile sent out to center field. Into the bushes and gone. So now to the plate, Mark Canna. Just low that time with the heavy sinker as it's ruled ball three.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
And a full count for Canna now. Three balls and two strikes.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
There's ball four. Next, it'll be Seth Brown. He went down on strikes in his last at bat. Canna gets his lead at first, nobody out. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
As a look, now the pitch. Now a swinging bunt. Another 2-2 offering. A runner at first with no outs here. Now a throw over, but the runner's back easily. Ripped down the first base line. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2.
Hey, having AB right here, I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Grounder down the line at third. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out. So a runner at first with one out now, and that means Matt Chapman will dig in at the plate. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. And that misses up and in 3-1.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
Little dribbler up the first baseline.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
So he got him swinging. Matt Chapman goes down for out number two in the top half. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. And he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2. Two balls and two strikes. The count to Chris Davis. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Breaking ball well inside and taken for ball three.
Good running count right here. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runner on first. He'll be off to the races on this pitch.
And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with two out. So now to the plate. Tony Kemp struck out in his last trip to the plate. Fouled away. Down the first baseline.
That ball
the whistle will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Here's the payoff pitch. Fouled off. One run on three hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the A's so far. Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. In at the plate is Sean Murphy. One of the bigger spots in the ball game so far. Base is juiced now with two away. One ball and two strikes to the A's catcher.
I got to count 1-2.
From the stretch, the 1-2.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put-away stuff.
Here's the 1-2 on the ground to the left side. Anderson picks it up, and he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there. And the run is in to score from third. It's a 2-0 ball game. Into the box now, Josh Harrison. Now this pitch is popped up. Playable for Grandal behind the plate. And he'll get under it to put it away in foul territory, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next it'll be the outfielder, Luis Robert. That nibbled the corner there, but missed. 2-1.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter. The 3-1. He sends it out to left field. Well hit. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
The first baseman.
Stepping in now, Jose Abreu in the dirt, and now let's see. And oh, they say beat the throw, safe at third. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch. The 2-1 home. And he looks at a hold strike three as the cut fastball's in there, and that's out number one. Next will be the left-hand hitter, Eloy Jimenez, popped into foul ground his last time up.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit. You make the pitcher work the way he did right there, and that's the end result. That one sticks with you for a while.
Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score. So here's Yoan Moncada. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. Not not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. Rolando Olson will take care of him at first, and that ends the inning. Ronaldo Lopez, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here.
Ronaldo.
Digging in next will be Starling Marte.
Head-to-head with Ronaldo Lopez. He's 1-for-4.
A little bit outside.
2-1. One strike in the count.
And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
And just when you needed a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk was certainly not on the agenda. He needs a bear down right here.
3-2 to the A's center fielder. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Waiting on it is Jimenez. One out. Next here is Matt Olson. He went deep last time up. Two and one to the A's first baseman. Lifted the other way out to left center. Jimenez is under this one. And that's out number two. So here's the cleanup hitter, Mark Canna. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. And he misses 2-1. And it's fouled away. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Vaughn will wait on it. As he puts this one away, the side is retired. And now here is Yasmani Grandal. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. Bouncer. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at bat.
Now back.
So to the plate is the White Sox DH. Gavin Sheets comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Lifted in the air to center field. Marte is under it, and that's the second out of the inning. So two out, nobody on. And up to the plate next is Andrew Vaughn. 1-1. Hit in the air toward the gap in right center. Right fielder is on the run. And this one bounds around against the wall. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double.
Now back. The second baseman. Baseball. Hernandez.
In now, Cesar Hernandez. Two balls and a strike to Cesar Hernandez.
Good time to be a nine-hole hitter right now. More than likely going to get a good pitch to hit. The top of the order is looming on deck. Good spot to be a good hitter right now.
Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery.
Ball three,
not close with the sinker that time.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Grounded to third. Chapman brings it in. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. The potential tying run for him at third base.
Ready with the 1-2. Swing and a liner. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. 1-2. Here it is. Again, he sends it out of play. Runners at the corners, two men out. Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball. This is on the ground over to first. And a base hit as that'll score the runner from third and tie our ball game at two apiece.
Now by the center fielder, Louis.
To the plate now, Luis Robert. Cut fastball and there's strike two. Got him swinging, and that's the third out. Into the box, Seth Brown. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. So one gone for the A's in their half of the sixth. And up next, the power hitting third baseman Matt Chapman. To two balls and two strikes now. Hits are now even at four apiece. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring up the big time power bat of right-handed hitter Chris Davis. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. In the air down the line and left. Jimenez is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So the next to bat will be Tony Kemp. It was a walk in his last trip. Chapman, the runner at first with two gone. High chopper over to the right side. He's got it, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. James Caprilia enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 32, James Caprilia.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and set to go is the veteran first baseman, Jose Abreu. The 1-1 home. Slow roller out to short. Reined in. And that's the first down. Next up, Emo Jimenez. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Swung on and missed. 1-2 now.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
Again, a 1-2. A shot down the first baseline. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
The batter, the third baseman, Yoan Moncada.
Into the box, Yoan Moncada. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
The catcher, Rondon.
Rondon with a 3-1 count now.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in the zone, or you just pitch around it?
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Oh. swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
Now that.
Striding forward now is the DH, Gavin Sheets. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. Three and one now.
Two on, two out with the base open here as a pitcher. You have to be awful careful. You just don't want to groove something here and give this guy a pitch that he can hit one out of the park on.
And that pitch misses for ball four. So some intrigue now as the bases are loaded here with two away. One and two now as that one's fouled off. A ball and two strikes. And he comes back to get him. So a great job pitching out of it with the bases loaded. Seventh inning ready to roll. And now it'll be the catcher, Sean Murphy. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7.
Now batting.
So the Oakland lineup turns over, and to the plate, Josh Harrison. In his last at bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
And he'll reach second now with one away. At the plate now, Starling Marte. And he lays off for a ball. Two and one. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder coming on. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. Now it'll be Matt Olson. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Go ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. And it looks like they'd rather go after the next guy as the intentional walk signal comes here with two away.
Now back.
Big spot here. First and second. Two men gone. And striding into bat next, it'll be Mark Canna. Fastball was too much for him there. Swung right through it.
He's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
To two balls and two strikes now.
Now two and two, two on, two out. This is when you have to make a pitch right here. The left.
That will have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. So now here is Cesar Hernandez. He was able to reach base thanks to an error in his last at bat. Now the 1-1 pitch. Drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play.
How about it?
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Tim Anderson. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. Two-two is a changeup that misses. 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. One and two.
Hey, this is a huge at-bat right here. This pitcher wants to end this inning and have 3, 4, 5 due up to start the next inning.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Striding in for Oakland, Seth Brown. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. And that'll bring in Matt Chapman. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Hits are even right now at 5 aside. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Here comes the 1-2. fouls this one off. The next 1-2 pitch.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get to Chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him. So we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
So he chased out of the strike zone on that one. Matt Chapman is sent packing for the second out of the inning. From the windup, the 1-1. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Ready now for the White Sox, Jose Abreu. And he'll start out the bottom of the eighth inning. The 1-1 home. There's a fastball that misses. And he drops a changeup right down Broadway for a called strike. 2-2.
We got full count.
Him up. Chapman is under it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Now to the plate, Ivo Jimenez. He doubled his last time up.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that run his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
2-1 to count.
Off-speed
pitch misses here, and he runs it to 3-1.
Three balls, one strike.
Yoan Moncada is on deck. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. Next to dig in, Yoan Moncada. No hits to this point. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way.
Helpful.
So a full count now. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And up next, the switch hitting catcher, Yasmani Grandal. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Tony Kemp. 1-1. Takes a pitch for strike number two. Ground for Hernandez at second base. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Next up for the A's, Sean Murphy. 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. The 2-1 home. Grounded back up the middle, and that finds its way into center for a one-out base hit. So now to the plate, Josh Harrison, a shortstop behind with a 1-2 count. And that misses 2-2.
Listen, I'm not trying to make up an excuse, but this is this guy's fifth inning of work in this game out of the bullpen. Are you kidding me? Nobody goes five innings anymore.
Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Ready with another two-strike offering. Anderson brings it in. He'll go to the bag for one. Back to first, a double play, and we stay tied heading to the bottom of the ninth. Ball set for the bottom of the ninth. And standing in is the DH, Gavin Sheets. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Now Andrew Vaughn, the next to bat.
Andrew.
One out, nobody on.
Vaughn.
Hit to short. Harrison's got it. And that's the second out. Now to bat, Cesar Hernandez. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point.
Hernandez.
The 1-1. Big swing, and this one's launched to right field and deep. Ball game.
Everybody wants to be a hero and hit one of those walk-off game-winning home runs. So you know right now when he's getting mobbed by his teammates, he has to feel awfully good.
The finish in tonight's game. The Pale Hogs came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Ronaldo Lopez is the winning pitcher of record. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious White Sox, 3 runs, 6